We worked before production properly kicked off. We worked loosely for about 5 months, and I'd do sketches in London, and Dan would do sketches in LA, and we'd talk on the phone. And we blocked out the main feel of the film.
So I supervise about 9 board artists, and I am kind of the gauntlet between Martin and the board guys to make sure that his vision gets up on the screen. And so it's like a little family, and then I take what they give me, process it, and then move it on to Martin, and we put it into an animatic and start to build the film.
We got very experienced artists such as David Roach, who's done a lot of stuff for 2000 AD, and he's got a very finessed, very beautiful sense of composition and drama. It comes from a very classy end of comic books.
In many ways, it is just the same as drawing a comic book because we're given a script and we just have to visualize it. But we've been given such freedom to run with the scenes and develop them, make them really sing, make them come to life. It's a strange project because you cannot be too over the top. You cannot be too violent for the Ultramarines.
We have another senior board artist is Graham Wynne-Jones, who is experienced in doing boards for live action commercials and for movies too. So his stuff is great for sense of action, whip pans, tracking, big explosive drama, which there's a lot of in this film.
It's been real fun, you know. I mean, you look forward to something like this all your life, to do stories of guys with machine guns and, wiping out bad guys. And hey, it's cowboys and Indians to me. It's great fun.
The toughest thing is to find the artists who are capable of delivering that wonderful anatomy and being able to draw characters in all kinds of positions in perspective with those really strong angles that you get from a live action or a comic book setup.
I've had characters jumping from bridge to bridge, and would they be able to jump with just one hand? Do they ever put their guns down? No, they don't put their guns down. Yes, they're strong enough to do everything one-handed.
Well, I read all the codexes, which were very important. It's something, I like to think of myself like an actor. I prepare myself. I'm methodical about, the characters, the universes they inhabit, and the conditions they have, and what the Ultramarines are sort of, will face there. All that inclusive kind of makes a very exciting package visually. So I like to try and get that over because, we've got a core fan base, and they're the people who will, the details will be very important for the audience, and we have to get that right, We have to get that right. It's important.
The whole time we've been trying to think, what would the fans love? So, I mean, I've done a lot of the storyboarding of the climactic battle at the end, and the whole time I've been trying to think, well, what's the most exciting way I can show this? So we've been really trying to push it as far as we can.